Rap City, what's going on? It's your girl Les, hanging out here on the West Coast now. You know I love my job, right? And you know I know everybody and their mama, right? Well, you see, me and Dr. Dre, we're like this. Gave me the keys to the house. Gave me open reign of the refrigerator. Les, go hang out. King T's gonna be there. Chill. Lay by the pool. Do whatever you want. Stay as long as you want. Who am I to turn down an offer like that? So King T, one of the godfathers of hip-hop, is gonna be hanging out with your girl. You know he's got album number 5 out, Thy Kingdom Come. 2 slamming joints. 3 on the way. Man, what more could a girl ask for? Rap City, don't go nowhere. Come on, have a willy attack with me. Hi, Drizzy. I'm glad you let me hang out at your house, but you know you gotta leave before the male strippers come. You said I could do whatever
all right,
I wanted
it's all
to
good.
Do.
You can make that happen.
All right. Now, the last time we kicked it, you on the set, you and LL doing the zoom
right,
thing,
right.
Which is off the hook, Star Jay.
Okay.
Now, what you been doing since then?
Working on my follow-up album to The Chronic right now.
Yeah. Woo, the world is waiting.
Doing that.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Now, you know, the whole world has been like, when you came out with Aftermath, everybody was like, all right, Dre's doing his thing. And then you hit us with a compilation.
Right.
Now it's all about Dr. Dre. Cool,
right.
You got your groups and everybody, but
right.
Everybody wants to hear from Dr. Dre.
Yeah, it's happening. I'm going to try to release in December, you know. I haven't even got a title for the album yet.
Really?
But, you know, I'm up to like 17 cuts. I'm probably going to go through about 50 of them, pick the best 16 and drop it.
Now, who else are you doing joints with? Because, you know, I've been asking the question, and I've been hearing a lot. Everybody who's coming out with albums got 50 million other artists, east, west, whatever, on their stuff.
I'm not really into that, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Because it's getting kind of played to me, you know.
Right.
You got, you know, these artists coming out, and every song is featuring somebody.
Exactly.
You know? So I'm not going to get wrapped up into that. I'm just going to do my thing that I've been doing, working with new artists, putting new artists on, and keep it like that.
Now let's talk about my man over there, King T. What's his story before I get over there and get all up in his business?
He has a super album coming out. It's
really?
Fly. It's called Thy Kingdom Come.
Mm-hmm.
And it'll be out real soon. This is the hottest.
Now, how many joints on that album did you do?
I did, let me see, 2, I think. Mm-hmm. It was 2 or 3, something like that.
Why is he kind of labeled one of the godfathers of hip-hop?
King T's been doing this thing a long time, and he's been keeping it live. He just hasn't blew up to the point he's supposed to be, you know?
Why do you think that is, though? Because he's, what, 5 albums deep now, almost a decade in the mix. What has happened that he hasn't been able to, like, blow up the chart and become just world renowned?
I think it had a lot to do with his record company,
mm-hmm.
you know, not knowing how to market the type of music he's doing. You know, I think that had a lot to do with it, but we're going to get it on for him this time.
Now, how would you compare your style to his style at all, or you guys are just totally 2 separate entities?
We're the same, but we're different.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, King T's style to me is a lot more just like that project street kind of just boom, that
mm-hmm.
kind of thing. Me, I'm just like, I'm gonna do some smooth out stuff right now. You know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right.
I'm gonna keep it live. I'm gonna get rugged with it, but you know, I'm probably gonna limit the profanity a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And just do it a little more smoothed out.
Is this a sign of maturity?
Ooh. I think so, definitely that.
Our Dr. Dre's growing up, y'all. He's growing up. Now about this golf course over here.
Right.
Can you play?
No, not a lick.
Well, let me teach
Tiger
you.
Tiger Woods, I'm not.
And I bet you some money, because I'm taking all of yours.
Because right.
I'm a whip.
Oh.
Money, you ain't got no game. See what I'm saying? Watch this. Back up on me. Leslie Woods, here we go. See,
mm-hmm. Talking about me, let's see.
He pushed me, y'all. He pushed me, didn't you see it? He pushed me. You get out here a lot, huh?
Not at all.
Me either.
Like I was saying, this became a stupid game to me when I found out I couldn't play.
You know what I'm saying? Who wanna play this game anyway? No, I know how you feel. I get like that too.
What's up, man?
You gotta say what's up to the fam.
Yo, what's up, BT? Yeah, back again.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
How did you two hook up? What's going on here?
Oh, man. Me and Dre been, like, knowing each other for years and always talked about working together and doing something. So when he left Death Row, I was looking for another, you know, home And he just called me up and was like, yo, come on, let's talk about it. He just signed me up. Didn't even hear a demo or nothing. He was just lovely.
That's because you got history, though. Who needs a demo? 10 years in the mix.
4 albums out.
You know? Yeah. Now, what's it like working with Dre for you? What did he bring out of you that, like, no other producer's been able to bring in?
Man, he Dre make you work, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. He's very serious in the studio, and he just wants you to put it down and do your best, you know what I'm saying? He bring all the good out of you, you know what I'm saying? What you're supposed to be doing, you know what I'm saying? Instead of in there, you know, partying and messing around and all that, come here to work.
Now, you know I gotta flip it, though, because I'm sure he made you get it together on your tracks, pull out all kinds of instrumentals.
Oh, yeah. I mean, we were just in there doing it, I mean. I don't know how many tracks we went through, you know. We just
went through a few.
Yeah. We just went in there and just say, okay, let's just keep doing it until we really feeling something.
Right.
I mean, we took trips to, you know what I'm saying? We recorded like at least 22 albums.
Are you serious? you guys got stuff in the vault. No, I'm not feeling that one today.
No doubt about it.
Now, how is this label situation better for you? And don't gas him because he's standing
here. No, it's lovely because the last labels I was with, like MCA and Capitol, they didn't really have no department. They really didn't know what to do with rap and things like that. So now I'm with a person that's affiliated with rap, and, you know, he's been giving me everything I needed, like, you know, any producer I want to work with, and, you know what I'm saying, anytime you want to go in the studio, knock it. I worked on this album for like a year and a half. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So it's been lovely. He let me take my time with it. That's what he told me to do. Just do, you know what I'm saying? Do what you want to do, and it's going to turn out right.
King T, your girl Les, hanging out here on Drizzy's golf course. Now, we know you got skills on the mic. Let's see what you can do with this. Go on.
We're right here?
Right there, baby. Wow. And it's close, too.
So how you do it, like this?
Not baseball, golf. No, we kidding. Hey. Oh, you're the worst. Hanging out at Dre's, man, King T.
What's going down?
We gonna put a thong on for y'all later because we over here by the pool and everything. Right?
Hold your breath.
Oh, you're the worst, man. Okay, the single that I love the most, Got It Locked Down. Why is that just banging in the club?
Man, that's something actually new for King T. That's what we was trying to do. See how King T is doing the club and things like that. Turned out pretty good. We just did a remix on it too.
I know you, J.O. and Dre.
Yeah.
Well, so, why didn't y'all do a video?
You know, it was just something we just, I don't know, because really we trying to put out this new single called Squeeze. Mm-hmm. And I did that with this new kid coming out called Baby S.
Right.
And that's produced by Battle Cat. So we trying to work on that, do a video for that. We're going to put the remix on the B side of that.
I say this every time somebody mentions Battle Cat's name. You don't bring your behind to Rap City,
I'm gonna
come find you, Battle Cat. Everybody gives him love and props. Yeah. I think I met him one time.
Yeah.
You know how
he's
it is.
He's the man. He's definitely the man.
Now, what's going on with this album in regards of tracks that reflect the King T of the 90s?
Man, I just feel blessed because I got to do whatever I wanted to with the album, and I got to work with some of my favorite producers like Butter and Stoopy Doo, and so all the tracks is real tight, you know what I'm saying? I sat with the album for like a year and a half trying to pick the best beats, so it's definitely a new King T, but with the kind of, you know, same act of fool type vibe to it, you know, keeping it real.
You keep saying new King T. Why did you feel like you had to come out and be something other than what everybody has always known you as through the rest of the other 4 albums?
Because I used to be, you know, on the, mm-hmm. on something different
the
back
in the day. You know,
I was young when I first started. I think I was around 16, 17 when I got my first deal at Capitol. So coming up, being so young, you do a lot of things. You don't handle your business
right.
And you know, you run around partying, messing with these girls, and you know what I'm saying? Just not really handling your business. So the new King T is the businessman, and it's not, see, back then it was just a game, and I made records and things like that. Now it's my job, and it's how I take care of my family. so I gotta handle it like that.
We're gonna talk about the title of this album, and I think Kingdom Come.
Yeah.
Y'all go ahead, go watch the video, come on back. Hopefully he'll be in his song when we come back, y'all.
Yo, yo, King T and Big Les just chilling at the Dr. Dre estate, you know what I'm saying?
We about to throw a wild party. Dre done left the building. He went to the studio,
yeah.
Y'all.
Woo! Yeah, it's on now.
I didn't warn you, but I got male strippers coming. So I'll stick you on the East Wing. I took care of you too.
What about the thong, though?
Oh, yeah, that too. No, we're going to do that before the show is over. You're going to give me a little private dancer.
That's right. That's right.
KT is back on the set, new album, Thy Kingdom Come.
Right.
Why did you call it Thy Kingdom Come?
Well, I guess it was because, you know, I feel I've been in this rap game a long, long time. I started out, you know, like in 85, 86 with my first album. And so it's been like 10, 12, 13 years, probably more than that. And I put out, this is going to be my fifth album. I then put out, you know, different groups, like started out different groups like The Alcoholics and Exhibit.
Yeah,
and things like that. And I just feel like I paid my dues, so I think I should get what's coming to me. So I'm ready to graduate from this, you know what I'm saying? Move on to something else, like starting a label and our production companies, things like that. Like you said, get into some movies or something.
Yeah, yeah.
You know.
When you say that you are waiting for what's coming to you,
yeah.
What would be like the ultimate satisfaction for you to say, all right, all of this hard work and all these albums have finally paid off?
Really, I'm not looking for nothing really too extravagant. I'll be happy with just a gold plaque. You know what I'm saying? Something to show my kids, you know, 10
Stop
years.
Stop lying, because you know you get one gold, you want three more platinums and some more multi-platinums. Come on,
nah,
stop lying.
Nah, I just want something to show my children, you know what I'm saying? Like, let them know I was here, you know, doing something and handling my business, you know?
Yeah. Now, what's coming up under this production company of yours? Because you got the Licks thing about to jump off.
Yeah.
You compared it to who?
Well, I'm loving the new Def Squad album and the Flip Mode things. So I'm trying to put together with The Alcoholics, Exhibit, the Farahe, Rue Lupac, Barbershop. We're trying to put together a liquid album, you know what I'm saying, and have everybody do different songs together, and you know what I'm saying, and that's what's going to spark off my label, our production deal, you know what I'm saying, whatever.
Do you have a name of the label yet?
Nah, we ain't came up with it yet. It'll probably just be something like Liquid Entertainment or something like that. Nothing, you know.
We
fancy.
Always call it Leslie Entertainment,
yeah,
King
you know.
T Associates. You know how
yeah. It goes. You get the contracts in the morning.
Hello. Remember he said that, y'all. Remember you heard him say that, all right?
Yeah.
We're going to just chill, maybe get out the sun, because I think both of us are looking like a piece of bacon right about now. We're going to go get some lemonade and see if any of the dancers got here yet. Take what your mama gave you.
With that.
Yeah. You love what we do. This is the life.
No doubt.
What would you do if you were not making records?
If I weren't making records, I'd still be involved with music somehow. Probably doing what you're doing, trying, you know,
talking to folks, flossing,
yeah.
Wishing they had you. Psych.
On the radio, or something, you know, because that's all I know is music.
Right, right. You were the first man to ever endorse.
Yeah.
How did they approach you?
Well, that was hooked up to this cat, Greg Mack. He used to be on K-Day out here in L.A. It was a new beer company, and he was just getting started. He wanted somebody to do, like, some rap commercials, and get out with Pool. And we just did it. And, you know, gave us a little change.
A couple of zeros, you know.
So it was cool. We started it off, and then it went on. We got Cube to do some, then we went to the East Coast, got like EPMD, Rakim, and a lot of people. And now it's just now, you know.
Yep, you set a trend. They doing Sprite commercials, yeah. Gap ads, no all kinds of things. No but doubt. did you get a lot of flack from doing that because it was alcohol, because it was, you know, liquor, and people, you have kids listening to your music, they feel like, did you get a lot of people, you know?
No, I think really all we got was like, man, that's a fat commercial, you know what I'm saying? And, you know, that's all we used to get was compliments on it. Chuck said a couple of things, you know, Chuck D, you know.
What'd he say? Come on. What'd he say? Keep it real, Scrap City. What'd he say?
He was mainly targeting the beer company for using rap, you know what I'm saying, and, you know, selling 40s to the kids and all that type of thing.
Right, right.
He actually had a suit against St. Ives.
Oh, really?
Because we was cutting his voice on the commercial.
There you go. You're a changed man, I must say. Your girl Les hanging out with King T.
Just chilling, man.
I need another strawberry. Garcon? Garcon? Where's the service around here? How's my man DJ Pooh?
Oh, man. Pooh chilling. I think they get ready to shoot. He's getting ready to shoot his movie.
Is he really?
Yeah, he's got a movie called Three Strikes that's coming out. He went and bought all the cameras and all the film and that whole editing studio and all.
Is not playing? Did he save you a part?
He told me he gonna throw me in something, you know. I don't know, but I'm gonna be on the soundtrack and things like that.
Okay.
You know,
hey, so. Pooh, if you're listening, actress of the year, hello.
No, for sure.
Now he got down on your last album. He got down on this album. What is it about Pooh that you want to keep working with him?
I don't know, it's just like the chemistry, you know, it's been me and him from the beginning, you know, and he actually mixed the new album we got now, Thy Kingdom Come. He mixed the whole album, and it's just, I gotta have him, you know what I'm saying? That's mm-hmm. my man, and we've been down since the beginning, since this all started out, and so I gotta keep it like that.
Does it surprise you that maybe he's going into film and television, or did you always kind of know it?
He's always been the type of person that just ventures off into different things and try to start, you know, new hobbies and things like that.
Right.
So I knew he'd be in the bigger and better things, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, we still cool, we still down, you know?
Your eyes, I know, have seen a whole lot over the last couple of years. Especially, you know, rolling through with Compton and hanging out with Easy and stuff. What was that time like for you? Take us there, man.
Oh, man, it was lovely, you know. It was a lovely thing being around Easy and Dre and everybody, from BG Knockout, Dre Star, all of them. And that was kind of like, you know, home for me, you know what mm-hmm. I'm saying? I wasn't really born there, but I lived there, and I was kind of educated on a lot of, you know, street life there in Compton. So that it was like home for me. And Mixmaster Spade, he showed me the ropes and all that. So it was lovely, man. And I'm still there, you know what I'm saying? We got, you know, my people's got record shops out there. I go out there like, I try to go like every other week and just go mm-hmm. sit at the record shops with the homies and just mess around, because that's my home, you know.
Do you still get down to Cypher? You roll through Compton, see some of your homies, and y'all just want to kick it in the Cypher like, what?
Nah, okay. I don't think too many could get with me yet, you know what I'm saying?
It's
nah, it's
I hear a challenge, y'all. I hear a challenge. Does that mean you're going to kick a freestyle for us later? Come on.
You know, ain't no thing.
And we going to put him on the spot, y'all. Don't go nowhere. Sit tight. KT going to kick a freestyle flow, y'all.
WC.
All right, KT, thank you for getting all my strippers, you know, together. I appreciate that. You know what I'm saying? We're judging the contest. No, I'm just bugging y'all. This is part of his fam. Introduce everybody, please.
Well, that's Superior Breeze right there, you know what I'm saying, from the Guns Click. Got an album coming out pretty soon. My man Step One, who's the producer of the single, got it locked and the remix.
That's right. What's up?
And
it's your phone too.
Oh, ain't that?
Look, y'all got to wait. We on Rap City right now. Call later.
And my man Mailman right here, you know what I'm saying? He's a producer. He done make it on the album. Cause you know, he's producing Dr. Dre's new album.
You see your largeness.
He's part of the crew, you know. And my man E right here.
What's up, Rap City?
Working on this new stuff. He's part of the Liquid crew and all that, you know what I'm saying? And this young lady right here is my manager, Charlie Henry.
Boogie.
The business, you know what I'm saying?
That's right. What's up, Rap City?
Yeah,
right.
Right.
So, now, what is it about King T's album this time around that's gonna make it like go multi-platinum?
It's banging harder than everybody else's album.
For sure.
Different recipe this time around?
Oh yeah,
a whole different recipe. You know, we got everything on the album this time. I think before, you know, he ran into some problems about maybe people didn't want to, people didn't, from the first single on, maybe, you know, it's, you know, sometimes the artist he is, you know, he got certain kind of fans, but now this time he coming out where his music is touching everybody. You know, it ain't just for the G's, it's for the G's and the B's, you know.
Okay.
Yeah,
next job.
Now, why did you choose to manage your mama?
Well, you know what, at that time I had come off a hiatus from managing the Lynch Mob. I worked with Easy for about 5 years. And at that time I really wasn't gonna do any more rap clients. But a friend of mine introduced me to him and said, help, he needs a little help, a little guidance. You my girl, that's my dude. We needed to do this and put it down. And I was such a King T fan, word up. You know what I mean? I was just like,
right,
you know,
right.
Will you manage King T? Yeah, I think I just reversed that clause. I definitely want some more rap clients. And I was such a fan of his. And I just couldn't refuse it. And we've been together since 95, putting it down. Got with Dre, and it's all history.
Okay.
And you will see that on Thy Kingdom Come.
Yeah.
For sure.
Well, T challenged the rest of the world to come at him. You just on a freestyle too. So you know what we're going to do? Stand back, y'all. The floor is yours, brother. Do your thing. Hold on. Go ahead.
Oh my G's, rock on. Get your ride on when you hear it. The forbidden gangland lyrics. Play your hater spirit. Get your ride up close near it. Possessed by the Eazy-E spirit. Dr. Dre set the limit. And won't cross this line. It's suicide. And won't cross this nine in your mouth. Puffing with my down south. What the is really all about, man? I'm coming out. Front back 98, boom. All you fake G's, stay home. Leave the shit alone. King T's back on the throne. And my is on the mic straight gone. Crazy. Y'all fools are the...
Talk to you. Don't
use
a cuss word.
I'm sorry, you know.
That's it, King T kicking the fist.
What?
That Kingdom Come, thought y'all knew.
Yeah.
Ah, Strawjay, baby.
Peace.
All right, Rap City, time for us to be out. King T, new album, Thy Kingdom Come, baby. All the joints, we got it locked.
Thank BT for having me out. You know what I'm saying? And anytime you want to come hang out, just come, just talk. You know what I'm saying? See how much the phone rang, you know, so. Thanks a lot.
We got Dre making our set of keys right now. Dre, our keys ready? Our keys ready to the house?
Oh, yeah.
All right, don't you have to go somewhere? We leaving. We got a party to throw. I'm saying.
All right, see you
then. Say goodbye.
Don't tear it up.
We promise.
Break it, you bought it.
We promise. Say goodbye, y'all. We out of here. Rap City holding it down. King T. Dr. Rizzi, you know what time.
Go buy the album.
Bye, y'all.